Welcome back, students. In the previous videos, we have discussed about Euler theorem. Now we are going to see some more properties or some more definitions on graph theory. So here it is a connectivity. Connectivity means connected graphs. So we see that whether the graphs are connected or not. So here it is a example is there. Here in this example, all the vertices are connected. So it is a connected graph. Is this a connected graph? No, it is not a connected graph. Why? Here there is no connection between A and D. So here all the vertices have a connection. So it is a connected graph. Here it is not having a connection. So it is not having a connection from A to D or from A to B. So it is not a connected graph. Connected graph means it must have a connected from, it must be connected from each and every vertices. If there is no connection between the vertices, then it is simply called as non-connected graph or disconnected graph. This is also a connected graph. So this is a connected graph. No, it is not a connected graph. Why it is not a connected graph? So why it is not a connected graph means, see here B to C, here A to F, here B to D, here A to E, E to F. But why it is not a connected graph? Connection means here it is also edges falling on this. So edge must not fall on this. That means it must not repeat it. So we can simply cut off this and we can say that it is connected. But why it is not connected means here I have taken A, B, C, D, E, F. So these two are equal, but they are not connected. Why they are not connected means they are falling upon one to one. So sometimes we can say this as a connected graph also. So in some cases we can say that it is not connected. In some cases we can say it is a connected graph. So these two are connected graphs and these are not connected graphs. In some situations we can easily say that it is a connected graph. In some situations we cannot say that it is a connected graph. So what are the connected components of the following graphs? So these are the connected components are the graph with vertices A, B, C, D, E is separate, F is separate, I, G, H, J are separate. So and directed graph is strongly connected. So here we come across strongly connected and weakly connected. In the previous example, it is weakly connected. In the previous example, it is weakly connected. But strongly connected means if there is a path from A to B and from B to A, whenever A and B are vertices in a graph, then it is said to be strongly connected. Otherwise, it is said to be weakly connected. So, and directed graph is weakly connected if there is a path between any two vertices in underlying the undirected graph, then it is said to be a weakly connected graph. So, these are some examples of a weakly connected graph. Weakly connected because, for example, there is no path from B to D. Here there is no path from B to D. Here there is D to B, but there is no path from B to D. So it is weakly connected. Here it is strongly connected. Why? Because there are paths between all possible pair of vertices. If we consider any vertices, there is a path. From A, if I consider, then there is a path. If I consider B, there is a path. If I consider C, there is a path. If I consider D, there is a path. So if each and every vertices is having a path, so it is strongly connected. It is not having some, it is having not having some or no path. So it is called as a weakly connected. But it is having all the vertices are having paths. So it is strongly connected, and this is a weakly connected graph. So Euler path and circuit. Again, I have written some definitions. Simple way I have written the definitions. Euler path means an Euler path is a multigraph is a path that includes each edge of a multigraph exactly once and intersect each vertex of a multigraph at least once. So this is the definition of Euler path. Euler circuit is an Euler path whose endpoints are identical, then it is called as a Euler circuit. So next, a multigraph is a transferable if it has a Euler path. Next, a connected multigraph has a Euler circuit if and only if all the vertices are of even length. So these are some of the definitions already I have discussed. So these are in a simple manner I have discussed here. Next, I go to next concept, that is Hamiltonian graph. Hamiltonian graph means here I will consider in the it is a case of a in case of a Euler graph I will consider vertex can be repeated, here edge can be repeated. A Hamiltonian graph is a graph with a closed path. So here the graph must be closed, that includes every vertex. Here vertex must be exactly one, no edge. Such a path of a cycle is called as a Hamiltonian cycle. So, or simply we can see the difference between Euler and Hamiltonian. And Euler circuit uses every edge exactly once. So Euler means edge exactly once, and Hamiltonian means we take every vertex exactly once. So the only difference between Hamiltonian graph and Euler graph is, in Hamiltonian graph every vertex will taken been exactly once, and in Euler it is each edge taken exactly once. So it is the only difference between Euler graph and Eulerian Hamiltonian graph. Hamiltonian graph. So each vertex exactly once, then it is called as a Hamiltonian path. Simply we can write this definition: each vertex exactly once is called as a Hamiltonian path. Next, a Hamiltonian cycle means first and last vertex are same. Here we are not considering any edge. We will consider the edge in Euler and we will consider the vertex in Hamiltonian. So first and last vertex are same, then it is called as a Hamiltonian circuit, or simply called as Hamiltonian cycle. So we have to put in mind that simple definitions are: Hamiltonian path means each vertex is visited exactly once, then it is called as a Hamiltonian path, and first and last vertex are same, then it is called as a Hamiltonian circuit or Hamiltonian cycle. A graph of vertices of a dodecahedron. So is it a Hamiltonian? Check whether it is a Hamiltonian or not. We have a conditions that each vertex exactly once. Here vertex must be chosen exactly once, it must be taken exactly once. Here we will not consider edge, we will see only vertex with each vertex is exactly once. So see that condition and say that whether it is a Hamiltonian or not. Yes, it is a Hamiltonian. If you want to check, you can easily check that each vertex is exactly visited exactly once. So it is an example of a Hamiltonian graph. So it is a Hamiltonian graph. This one has a Hamiltonian path. It is having a Hamiltonian path, but it is not having a Hamiltonian circuit. So it is not a Hamiltonian graph. So Hamiltonian graph. This one has a Euler. It is has a Euler circuit, but it is not having a Hamiltonian path. So this is an example of a Euler, but it is not a Hamiltonian. Next, spanning trees. So these are some of the definitions, very very important in. So spanning trees means, so first of all, before knowing the definition of a spanning tree, we will discuss about the definition of a tree. So a tree means a connected graph with no cycles is called as a tree. That means its edges is called as branches. So if we consider a connected graph, it must have with cycles, no cycles, it must have no cycles, then it is called as a tree. So its edges are considered as branches. So a tree has branches and its edges are considered as branches. So some of the points we discuss in the tree is, a tree with n vertices has n minus 1 edges. So this is the important condition. A tree with n vertices, n greater than 1, has at least 2 vertices of degree 1. So this is the another condition. So if we take a subgraph H of G, is called a spanning tree of the G if it satisfies the two condition. One condition is H is also a tree. So if we take a graph G and H is a subgraph of G, then it must satisfy the two conditions, then we so say that it is a spanning tree of G. That is, the first condition is H is a tree, and the second condition is H contains all the vertices of G, then we say that it is a spanning tree. So examples of a tree: it is a tree with no cycles. Here there are no cycles, so it is an example of a tree. So cycle graph. Cycle graph means starting and ending with same vertex or vertices is called as a cycle graph. That means if we start from one point and we end for the same point or same vertices, then it is called as a cycle graph. A tree with only one vertex is called as a trivial tree. If it is having only one vertices, then it is called as a trivial tree. If it is having more than one vertex, then it is called as a non-trivial. So the definition for trivial tree means a tree having only one vertex is called as a trivial tree, and it is having more than one vertex, then it is called as a non-trivial tree. So these are some of the definitions of a tree. Next is spanning tree. A graph which contains all vertices with minimum number of edges is called as a spanning tree. Spanning tree means the only condition is it must have minimum number of edges. So the edges must be less. So if you take any example, if you take any graph, it is having n vertices, then it must have, the spanning tree must have n minus 1 edges. That is, one edge must be less to know that it is a spanning tree. If we consider this tree, then it must be a spanning tree, then we have to take one edge. That means we have to delete one edge, then simply it becomes a spanning tree. The only condition between tree and a spanning tree is a tree will have n vertices and a spanning tree will have n minus 1 edges. That is the only difference between tree and a spanning tree. So obtain the spanning tree for a graph G. So obtain the spanning tree. Here, suppose if we take this as a tree, if we remove one edge, then it becomes a spanning tree. So here I have removed the edges. So it becomes a spanning tree. By deleting one edge from the given graph, I will get a spanning tree. Next, a binary tree. A rooted tree T is called a binary tree if every internal vertex T has out degree of 1. So if it is having out degree, means outside the degree of, is called as out degree. Inside means inside, internal means inside, external means outside. So a rooted tree T is called as a binary tree if every internal vertex of T has out degree of 1 or 2, then it is called as a binary tree. So complete binary tree. What is the definition of a complete binary tree? A rooted tree T is called as a complete binary tree if every vertex of T is of out degree 2. If the out vertex of T is 2, degree is 2, then it is simply called as a complete binary tree. So a complete binary tree means it has a out degree of 2, then it is called as a complete binary tree. So these are about the some of the trees. So this is the concepts on trees.